So I'm you know, I like the opportunity to be able to talk about that. We've had every kind of press through River Rock in the world, and everyone is really focused on how is this done? How is this legal? How are you able to regulate this? No one's actually just asked, you know, what's going on medically? Like, is there really any significance? Is it all made up, you know? And so I really appreciate the time to for your audience, and hopefully the words that I speak today speak loud to patients all around the world.
Yeah. When is that study going to come out, or that thing from the...
I don't think you're going to miss it.
No? Well, no. Don't be too sure. Is it this month?
There's some drafts being done already, because in Florida and New York, you have two bills being trying to be pushed right now. And so you've got pure CBD bills, okay, where in New York or in Florida, they think they're doing the public a favor, or they're saying this one particular strain and that's it. That's all you can grow, and that's going to be your treatment or your cure. That's just not true. And that's an ignorant way to look at the actual plant. Anyone that's in science would say to you, there's not enough information, but we know the results are there. We need to discover and keep going. So they're actually drafting letters, those scientists, for congressional statements this week, actually today, tomorrow, and Monday in New York. And those statements are going to get recorded, exactly what I said to you, but coming from the science community. And so they're going to get in there. It's kind of something that we're trying to really pitch as a deck to get them to understand. International Drug Policy Alliance came through here. We're working with them to really translate this message to parents. And so we don't want a rule to be passed or something to be passed that doesn't allow parents to really get access to what they're looking for is just results. So if you make it so it's hemp only, that's impossible to grow. They know that. So this is going to really push the medical community away. It's going to push everything away. And so you have to really look at it as an overall approach, you know, to science and medicine, and actually take it for real. So that's really the first condition. You have to get believers. And so the only way to get believers is to have results, and not just, you know, somebody walking around saying something. Like, you have to have those actual tests before and after. With the little girl as an example, I didn't introduce raw cannabis juice until month 5. I only introduced one element at a time and studied it and watched what it did. And then the GI was the last thing. And so I said, okay, I want to show you the miracles of this raw cannabis juice, because there's Dr. Christie and different people that have actually produced this, and everyone calls them quacks or they're out of their mind. People don't make claims about their wives or loved ones that have cancer, that are going to die, that are in cancer-free state. That's just not, it's not something that you really joke about. And so when it happens, it's significant. They don't know why. They don't know why yet. And so what we have to do is have these little significant discoveries. And so in that little girl, we tracked her entire GI. And the mother was very interesting how she presented it to me. She said, I want to show you something. Here's what a healthy diaphragm looks like. Here's what a healthy GI looks like. And this is what a stomach should look like without lesions. Let me show you my daughter. 30 days ago, we had it scoped, because like I said, she's a nurse. And she said, look at this diaphragm. It's white. It's vascular. It's closed. Look at her lesions on her stomach. I'm like, okay. Do you have anything that could show me what happened with the last 30 days with the raw cannabis juice? And she just smiled. She goes, the images that I showed you of what's supposed to be healthy is her. And then I said, okay, can I get a clean GI bill from your doctor? Which he provided 2 days later. So these are significant discoveries that will be released to the public. It's just, we've never had the access to say 10,000 patients and create these case studies. There aren't very many owners that you'll find actually individually meeting with patients and trying to create products and protocols and non-psychoactive programs to help patients. You know, I just personally hadn't seen that. I've just taken that on because I've been a patient since 1996, and I started as a caregiver, you know, with 3 lights and 6 plants. And then I started to help 3 or 4 people, and then 10 people, and then 100 people. And then partners came together, like-minded individuals came together, and we said, hey, we can't help patients out of our basement. We can't help 100 sick patients out of growing out of our basement. And that's when 1284 and the regulation developed. And everybody really was against it. But what that's done by regulating it and keeping it safe and out of the hands of children and street dealers and everything, you're able to control it and then analyze it and then test it and then document it. And so now the next step is releasing that program, the Act Now program, not to centers, but to doctors. So now my next thing is going to be providing that guideline and that software and that program to the doctors, because they have a lot more understanding of their patient. They're qualified to talk to their patients. I'm not a doctor, right? And so if they're on three or four different types of drugs and I give them a guideline to follow and they're able to track those patients, it's like arming a soldier to become like a 300. You know the movie 300? And so you have one individual that can take on thousands and thousands. Those are the doctors. If I try to take it on myself, it'd be like myself walking out taking on the Persian army. It's impossible. And so I realized that a few months ago. So after you have these discoveries and you see one after another patient, after patient getting into remission or getting into a 99% management, at that point you owe it to the world to get that information to the doctor's hands and the scientists, so that that way they can use that guide. And that's really what the next chapter is for Act Now. It's an independent situation from River Rock. So it's going to be a really exciting, certified program that will allow doctors to have a basis of all the information I just gave you.